single one of you are frontline fighters in this effort. That's why you're here. We have 30 days, or just about 30 days, till we go to the COP. That's the moment of accountability for all of these countries that promised in Paris we'd produce the 100 billion. I know what happened in my country, that a president who didn't believe in climate change pulled out of the Paris Agreement and stopped the money from flowing. So happily, President Biden has turned that around. He doubled the amount of money the minute he came in, and now at the UN last week, he doubled the doubling to $11.4 billion so we can get towards the 100 billion. But still, wait a minute. We know that that's not enough. A lot knows it's not enough. We're dealing with trillion-dollar economies. The UN Finance Gap Report tells us that we need to have 2.6 trillion to 4 trillion every single year for the next 30 years. The IEA tells us we have to deploy renewables 6 times faster than we are today. We have to build forests 5 times faster than we are today. We have to stop coal 5 times faster than we are today. We have to deploy electric vehicles 22 times faster than we are today. So we're behind. And we have to stop the BS that is being thrown at us by a number of countries that have not been willing to sign up to what Great Britain has signed up to, we've signed up to, Japan, Canada, the EU. That is to keep 1.5 degrees alive. And how are we doing it? Britain has promised a 78% reduction over the next 10 years. EU, 55%. UK, the United States, 50 to 52%. Japan, 45 to 50%. Canada, 45 to 50%. So we're on target. 55% of global GDP is on target to keep 1.5 degrees alive. You have to insist. You have to light up the internet. You have to light up social media. You have to do everything you can in this lead up to the COP to make certain that we are pushing other countries to do more than they have been willing to accept today so that we can, over the next 10 years, keep the 1.5 degrees alive. Now, I know because I've been there. In the 1960s, 70s, we were in the streets. And we made a difference by pushing, holding politicians accountable. And if they weren't going to be accountable, we threw them out. We literally did that. And that's how we passed the Clean Air Act, the Safe Drinking Water, Marine Mammal Protection, Coastal Zone Management. That's how we created our Environmental Protection Agency. Literally. Now, we have to get back to work to hold people accountable. And nobody does that better than young people all around the world through all of history. Every major movement for civil rights, for women's rights, for equality, to deal with the environment, to try to build housing, to have health care, always have come from young people who have been willing to go out and put themselves on the line in order to get the job done. So I'm with Franz Timmermans and I'm with Locke Sharma. We believe more has to happen, but we can't do it against some of these powerful interests that want to continue business as usual unless all of you join in this effort to build the momentum to hold everybody accountable. That's what has to happen at COP26. A new level of transparency and accountability. And we can do it with today's technology. We have real-time input through satellites as to what the supply chain footprint of carbon is for any company in the world, for any country in the world. So we have a new level of accountability, new insight of what countries are willing to do. So I simply say to you, thank you for coming here. Thanks for being part of this effort. But remember, I always remember the words of Robert Kennedy in South Africa when we were fighting apartheid. And he said, when he was in Joburg giving a speech at the university, he said, the greatest of all dangers is futility. The belief that there's nothing that one man or one woman can do against the enormous array of the world's ills. He said, each of us can work to change a small portion of events. And then the total of all those acts is written in history of this generation. Each time a man or woman strikes out against injustice or works to improve the lot of others, he or she sends forth a tiny ripple of hope. And crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build the current that sweeps down the mightiest wall of oppression or resistance. We have a wall of resistance staring at us still. We have to sweep it down. Help us do that. Thank you.